It's International Women's Day, where we champion the contributions women everywhere make to society. On behalf of Susan and I, you are welcome. But a new report card shows that on the road to equality, there's still a really long way to go.
OK, Australia, time for a gender equality vibe check. Safety.
Every woman, everywhere, has moments in her life where she feels afraid.
The numbers paint a grim picture. 16 women killed already this year, allegedly at the hands of men.
We're still expected to make ourselves safe rather than live in a society which is safe. And so, we really haven't gone very far.
OK, are we doing better at work?
It's a lot better than it used to be. I think women are talking much more frankly about some of the things that can get in their way.
But a couple of stark stats. 60% of managers are men and just 9% of top CEOs are female. Women are also much more likely to work part-time than their male colleagues. The reason? Looking after the kids.
I think give work life for women at the moment maybe a C, and that's a small improvement.
That improvement coming from the government's commitment to cheaper childcare and encouraging more men to take parental leave.
You can try and thrust women back into the workplace, but if men aren't going to start carrying half the load, then there's a big gap there. So I definitely think supporting paternity leave is a big step.
So what does this all mean for our finances? The gender pay gap is closing, but it still sits at 19% when bonuses and super are taken into account. Speaking of super, women retire with 25% less of it than men. And mums who split up from their partners see their income drop by almost a quarter.
We have women retiring not only having earned less their whole adult lives, but also having taken breaks from the workforce, which means they don't have the same superannuation. The system itself isn't fair.
To help make retirement easier, yesterday the government announced super would finally be included in parental leave payments.
It is the right thing to do because the government values the work that women do caring for children.
I mean, I'm going to give the government a few points on that. Maybe a C?
And we have clawed our way up from 43rd on the World Gender Equality Rankings to 26th, but that progress just highlighting how far we still have to come.
We want an Australia that is actually gender equal. It means that women can live free from violence. It means men can undertake careers in caring without feeling like they're the only ones.
When we can share those roles, then I think we can start turning International Women's Day into a celebration.
Because obviously International Women's Day, the hope would be it's a celebration.
Yeah.
But in 2024, does it feel like it just amplifies a lot of these issues?
Yes, yes. I would say yes, and also just looking out at our audience while we were running that package, I did notice that a lot of the women in the crowd just kept slinking down in their seats. They'd been like, yep, yep, yep. And so sometimes that can feel really overwhelming. Like, have we actually made this kind of progress? Mm. I mean, I think back, though, to a couple of things in the last 12 months that have at least buoyed my spirits a little bit, the Women's World Cup and the Matildas and what they are doing.
You almost never speak about
them. I never speak about the Matildas and what they have given, I think, younger girls in this country but also hopefully around the world in terms of what they can hope for, what they can strive for, and also the Barbie movie, more in terms of the economic success of that and having content that is purely driven for a female audience and showing the power that that also has.
Is the difficulty maintaining the momentum, though, when that happens?
Yeah. Look, I think that there is... I think it's really important to acknowledge momentum when you can say the word. I also think that it's, you know, we need to look at all of it at once. Like, it needs to be a discussion and a celebration of women's progress and of the things that need to be done. But it's not just about the economic success of Barbie and the Matildas, but of, like, the focus has changed. It's not really just about young women and about young girls seeing this. It's about young boys and people of all genders, you know, embracing that this is the norm now, that it's not... We're not talking about women's sport, we're talking about sport. And, you know, it's not about women directors, it's about directors and that we're changing the conversation that way.
Yeah, and I think that's the conversation that hopefully we can think about more when it comes to International Women's Day in the future.